We're doing it up. And this is for my travel bloggers. This is for my people looking to grow. And today we are going to be talking about some traffic. I talked a lot about how to get followers and subscribers in my previous video. So if you didn't check it out here. But today I want to dive into how to actually get that traffic and just get seen everywhere. So SEO is going to be your best bet for this. There's different tools that you can use to do this, but if you even just use Google alone, that will help you out just to give you an idea of what people are searching for. When you do this though, make sure you're in incognito mode, because otherwise the algorithm is going to think this is what you specifically are searching for, which you don't want Google to just assume that you're looking for this item. You want to see what people are actually looking for on Google, and you want to get in with those people, because the more people you get in with, the more traffic you get to your channel. It's all about your keywords. You want to use as many keywords as you can that are relevant to your topic. So that's where it gets tricky, because for example, I know I keep using Vegas as an example, but I just did so many videos on them, so that's why I keep talking about them. But you do Las Vegas, and it's also a room review. It's a hotel room review. So now here's three things. You could say Las Vegas, and if you look at your competition, that's going to be so many different things, so much competition, where if you look at Las Vegas hotel room, still a lot of competition. Las Vegas hotel room on the Strip, so much competition still. So how are you going to niche that down? Well, now you're going to say Harrah's Las Vegas room review. You want to get as many keywords in your title as you can. Same with all across social media, you're always allowed this many characters. So you want to fill it up with all the keywords that you can think of. And don't forget your hashtags and your tags, because all these things help Google figure out what the heck you're talking about. Because if you're talking in your video, now they even tune into your video. So make sure you're saying your keywords in your videos, you're putting them in your imagery, like in the alt text, you're putting them in your descriptions, in your titles, even if you want to put it as your first comment to add more keywords if you think of it. But all of this helps Google as a platform direct everybody to everywhere. As you notice, everything connects, and everything connects for a reason, just like how all your social media and all that stuff should connect for a reason, because it should be this constant flow of people checking you out here, then they see you again here. And in monetization, you should always remember it takes at least 6 points of interest before somebody will even make a sale. So the more traffic you get is the same idea. Like if somebody sees 6 things of yours that they like, they're probably going to subscribe. Honestly, people usually subscribe if they only see 1 or 2 things, but the ideal is just to get seen as many times as you can, and people are most likely going to follow you. I'm going to go a little into detail about some of the social media that I use and how I get more traffic. So in Pinterest, I do a mix of viral stuff and also my own stuff and also things that are coming up in the season. So for example, right now it's going to be Halloween. I had a post last year that went viral multiple times throughout the year, actually. Like people were still looking at fall comments even in February, or even in the summer. So this is something that is just rotating virally all the time. You can check it out in my blog. I'll put the link down below. But this content right here has been my winner. And it's the most random thing. I, at that time, was making a lot of fall captions for my own Instagram. And I was like, oh, these are pretty funny. I'm like funny, and I think people would like them because I'm funny. So I just put it up on Pinterest, just put it up. As you can see, I didn't even use that many graphics or anything, but it blew up and people saved it. And that's what you want to aim for on Pinterest, is get people to save your content. The more boards that you can get on and the more people that you can get to save your stuff, the more you're going to be seen across their audience, and then they're going to save and across their audience, etc., etc. TikTok is another one that I love. The stuff that I make on TikTok and I reshare on other platforms is going viral. I had this one that I did on Instagram, and this one went super viral and a lot of people shared it. And it's just this little piece of content that I made that was a viral trend, and it did really well for me. So it's really, it could be anything. The whole idea to get traffic is just put as much out there as you can. And Instagram is the same way. They want you to post in your story, on your reels, on IGTV, on your actual feed. It's a lot of work. They are really trying to get people to stay on their platform. YouTube is a great way for you to go viral because they are centered on search engine optimization and they actually show up first. If you notice, whenever you Google anything, YouTube is right up there at the top and your video has a chance to get up there too. So you want to get recommended by other people in your genre's videos. So going back to my Mexico video, if somebody is looking for Royal Hideaway Playa Car, maybe my video will show up in the recommendation. And maybe the first video was only one video, but now they see my video and they're like, oh, let me keep looking at more stuff because this one's a room tour. Oh, this one is a resort tour. Oh, this one is, you know, and they fall into this habit of watching all the videos that are in there for you. And a lot of times you can actually get recommended more than once just because you have similar keywords in your own video. YouTube Shorts also brings in a lot of traffic because they have that similar TikTok Reels vibe. And what I do is I just repurpose my content and post it on YouTube also. I haven't had any of my shorts go viral, but I do see a lot of new traffic onto my channel because I'm focusing more of my shorts on my actual like room tours and the content that I actually have on my YouTube and not just random fun videos that I'm doing on Reels and TikTok. However, my strategy may change for my second year of blogging. Who knows how it goes? Think about what is best for you. For example, if you're a gamer, like you're gonna be on Twitch. Like you wanna be on Twitch, that's where the money is. You wanna be on TikTok, getting traffic to Twitch. Like those are your main platforms. YouTube is awesome for you too. But in this video, we're talking about travel blogging. So I have found honestly that Pinterest is the best, Instagram is the best, and so is YouTube. Like those are my three top things for travel videos. So find out which platforms work best for you and then just repurpose that content and put it on your other platforms and it'll save you a lot of time and also bring you in a lot of views. Like I'm talking views on views on views on views. The best way overall to get more traffic is to have good content. And by good content, this is a visual stimulation platform. So if you're on YouTube, you want to have great video with good lighting. You don't want to be like in the dark in the corner of your closet or something. But think of it in regards to your traffic that you want to attract. So maybe if you are doing scary movies, you want to attract those people who want the dark, but we're doing travel videos. So most likely people are thinking about the beach. They're thinking about being somewhere bright and sunny. They don't want to be thinking about the cold and like shivering. So I try to keep my colors light and bright and I try to keep my pictures light and bright. And unless it's Vegas, because we're always out at night, those are darker videos, but I tend to keep most of my stuff on the lighter side. So even when you do down to your thumbnail, make sure your thumbnails are bright and colorful so they attract somebody's eye. And look at your competition when you're making your things, because if this is viral or that is viral, people are more likely going to click on that link than they would on just some random picture or some random photo or some random thumbnail. And don't just put out content, because if you just put out content, 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 people are gonna get tired of seeing you every day putting out this garbage. And they're going to probably call you out on it and they're going to unfollow you. So you're actually gonna lose traffic by not putting out quality content. In the travel industry, if you're just putting out the same five facts every day, eventually your audience is going to think, hey, I already learned everything I can learn from this person. So you're gonna start losing traffic where you want to gain traffic. So think of creative ways. Maybe it's the five same tips, but it's five different spins on the same trip. Like maybe one's for the beach, maybe one's for camping and one's for skiing, one's for the city, one's for the country, whatever you wanna do, but put different spins on it to keep your current audience interested. And different spins on it will also attract a new audience, but that will keep your audience engaged and it will also help you to attract new traffic. We're going to be on to the next video. I hope you're learning a lot from my first year blogging, and I hope you have a great year blogging too.